With the Google Pay API for Android, you can facilitate payment transactions for your users, making the checkout experience in your application more convenient. Join other businesses like yours who are using Google Pay today to drive user growth, increase conversions, and reduce data exposure and transactional vulnerabilities. Here is how you can integrate Google Pay on your Android application in 4 simple steps. Configure your project, determine readiness to pay, show the Google Pay button, create a payment data request object. First, add the Google Pay library to the list of dependencies in your application module. Make sure to review our documentation to check the latest version available. You also need to enable the Google Pay API in your manifest. You can do that by adding the following tag inside of your application node. As soon as you are ready, open the activity where you plan to show the Google Pay button and obtain a new instance of the payments client inside of your onCreate method. Note that the getPaymentsClient method takes a wallet options parameter. Use the definitions in this class to specify the environment in which you want to operate, test or production. For the test environment, you don't need to register with Google. You can play with the API yourself and integrate into your application. In this case, you can use real payment information. However, whenever a selection is made, we return you a non-chargeable token. Remember, your real card details are never used when in environment test, but you must add at least one chargeable card to your Google account before you proceed. Once you complete the integration and you are ready to handle real payments, come and register with us through our self-service portal and then flip the environment to production. You can apply for production access on g.co/pay/sign-up. Now that you have your payments client constructed, the first API you need to call is ready to pay. With is ready to pay, you can determine whether the user has a valid payment method on file and is capable of completing a transaction on a supported device. This request takes parameters that specify the API version targeted in your call, as well as the payment methods allowed for this transaction. At Google, we focus on optimizing for conversions, so if is ready to pay returns false, we highly recommend that you do not show the Google Pay button. Now that you know that the user is ready to make a payment using Google Pay, you can make the button visible to the user. We recommend that you use the graphics shared in the developer documentation to ensure the Google Pay branding is used correctly per our latest guidelines. In this bundle, you will find drawable and layout resources that adapt to different screen sizes and resolutions, as well as translations into multiple languages for the text in the button. Once the user taps on the button, you call the Load Payment Data request to open up the payment sheet. You can construct the Payment Data Request object, which is a set of payments configurations used for this particular transaction. You can request additional information, like a shipping address and email address, in addition to the payment credentials. We recommend that you collect as little information as necessary to prevent users from typing additional information which might not be stored in their accounts. One more point to call out in this object is the payment request tokenization parameters. Google encrypts information about a user's selected card for secure processing by a merchant's gateway or directly on a merchant's secured servers. Be sure to check your processor's integration guidelines to find out what they need to finalize the payment. Now that you've constructed the request object, you can pass it to Load Payment Data, an asynchronous task which opens the payments sheet. Once the user makes a selection, we return to you a payment data object as an activity result, which consists of metadata about the user's selection. It also includes the payment token, which you can use to complete the transaction. Now you can send the final production-ready application to Google for a final test. Google tests the app with real cards and informs you if everything is correct. The app is then cleared to launch. You can find additional information in our developer documentation on g.co yandex.co/pay/API. Don't miss any future videos about Google Pay and Android, and subscribe to the Android Developers channel. If you are watching on a mobile, tap the little bell to receive new upload notifications. See you soon!